Shalom, my name is Rabbi Danielle Upbin in Clearwater, Florida, and it is a privilege to be sharing this Torah Minute with you for B'nai Torah congregation in Boca Raton. I want to share with you a teaching about Shabbat Sukkot. So on Shabbat, we do not take up the lulav and etrog, although all the other days of Sukkot we do. But I want to relate the lulav and etrog to this moment, to who we are as a Jewish community. So the Midrash says that these arba minim that we take up during the holiday represent four different kinds of Jewish people. We have the etrog represents the heart, right? And people in our lives who are fragrant, who are hearty kind of people, right? Who lead with love, that is the etrog. Next, we have the lulav. The lulav is the backbone. People in our lives who stand firm for what they believe in, stand strong, moral compass facing north. And we also have the hadas, that is the myrtle, represents a good eye. It looks like little eyes here. A good eye, a kind eye. Ayin tova, not so critical, looking for the good in other people. And finally, we have arava, which is the weeping willow. And this represents the mouth, kind of looks like a smile. People who are gracious in their speech, kind words, arechat svatayim, who know what to say, who know how to say it, make people feel good. We're not expected to be all of these things, but we are expected to come together as a community, naguda achat, as one group. We bring the lulav and etrog and the hadas and the arava together as the four minim, because this is a community that celebrates all of these things together. These are the values that we live by. These are the values that we celebrate life, that we live life to its fullest and connect to each other as a strong and healthy community. In this week's Torah portion, we are also looking on Shabbat at Ki Tisa in Parshat in the Exodus chapter 34, where God gives us the 13 attributes. So if we lose our way or we need a little help, God says, be like me, Adonai, Adonai, al rachum v'chanu, be gracious, be merciful, be compassionate, be kind, be forgiving. And we find those very values in this week's Torah portion that we read together on Sukkot. Wishing you a wonderful, happy new year, a sweet and healthy and unified Sukkot. Shabbat Shalom.